Subterranean Challenge virtual competition is mirroring the systems track in a lot of ways. It still has the same diverse and challenging underground environments. It has mobility challenges and communications degradation, all of the same kind of things that we expect in the systems track, but it's more software focused. So the teams in the virtual track are competing to develop software to explore these highly diverse and challenging underground environments, and it's all done in a simulated environment.
We use the virtual world as a learning opportunity for us. It gave us, basically a simulator where we were able to practice and fine-tune our algorithms than we actually use in our systems, actual physical robots. So lots of what we learn running the virtual courses was then used in designing our approach for the physical world.
The virtual competition has a lot of diverse elements that you may not actually be able to test in the real world. Not everyone has access to the robots and the buildings and the underground tunnels that you would need to test the autonomy solutions fully and ensure that they're robust to all of these different types of environments. So it's really helpful to be able to test in these virtual environments first, and then you can take your solutions and put them on an actual robot.
So the virtual world, as we, once we saw it, gave us hopefully some idea what to prepare for in the systems world as well. Before the virtual world became available, we really didn't have a clue if we are talking about subway stations or, what kind of shopping malls, what kind of environment. And that can make a huge difference in what you are preparing for.
In the systems track, you actually have a human supervisor who is able to provide high-level inputs to their robot team. In the virtual track, you submit a software solution that has absolutely no human interaction. It has to be completely autonomous and make all of those higher-level decisions that a human operator would normally do. And that is a really impressive thing that our virtual competitors are doing.
In virtual, I was able to get all of the drones to work for this circuit. And so I used a team of quad rotors to do the exploration and mapping for the virtual circuit. What we've done in the virtual track only applies there, and what we've done in the system track only applies there. What we'd like to do is be able to simulate what happens in the systems track and then share the code back and forth and improve our efficiency.
We're both creating more worlds and more realistic worlds based on things like this urban circuit competition, which we will actually be creating a world that is representative of the system track courses. And we're also adding a bunch of new robot configurations and robot models to the SubT tech repo for the next circuit so that teams can actually have the capabilities of these new robots to be able to climb stairs and steep inclines and go through vertical shafts and some of those more challenging environments.